In this short video, I'm just going to highlight a little bit more how to code some of the form logic I showed you in part four. As you'll see, first of all, we have begun two groups by writing begin group into the type column and then giving our groups names, intro.odk and prev.year. We have not given them labels, but we can do. This will then give text, which will appear on the screen when the user is answering these questions. Now, you remember that whenever we open a group, we also have to close it. Here, we are ending a group by putting end group into the type column. When you do this, it will be ending the group most recently begun. So in this example, we will actually be ending the prev.year group with this line. It would be good practice, though I've forgotten to do it here, to include the name of the group you are planning to end in the name column, simply just to remind yourself. As I said, we have to end every group we start, so the intro.odk group is actually ended right at the bottom here in this last line. Similarly, we also begin a repeat group here, which is ended here. You'll notice that we have given this a repeat count of $open curly bracket plan.holidays close curly bracket, meaning this will repeat depending on the number given to this question here just before it. Now, with this first line in the repeat itself, we are actually doing a calculate to get the position of the repeat. What this means is using this position open bracket dot dot close bracket, we are calculating which number of iterations the group is currently on. So if this is the first time it's asking the questions, this variable will equal 1. If it's the second, it will equal 2, and so on. And hence, we are then using this new variable in the label for our next question, meaning this will actually read in the end, to which continent do you intend to travel for trip number 1, and then trip number 2, and then trip number 3, until we have reached the number of our repeat count. Next, we also have included a few constraints within our form. Specifically, you'll notice 2 here, for which the answer to these questions cannot exceed 366. Or in more specific terms, the answer to these questions must be below 367. This is because we do not want somebody to say they're having more trips abroad than there are days in the calendar year, as this seems quite an unreasonable answer to expect. Similarly, towards the bottom, we have the constraint that I showed you in the slides, where this question, 11.B, cannot be equal to question 11.A, and 11.C cannot be equal to either of them. And then finally, we have a relevancy, or a skip pattern in more general terms. What you notice here is that we have begun a group of questions. Now, both questions 6 and 7 are irrelevant if the user has never traveled abroad, a question which is asked beforehand in question 5. Have you ever traveled abroad? Therefore, in the relevancy column for this begin group line, we have set it so these two questions only appear if the answer to question 5 was yes. If it was no, then these two questions here will not appear for the user. Thank you for listening to part 4 of these presentations. In the next part, I'll look more into how to upload your finished XLS form onto an ODK aggregator ready for data collection.